गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, वी आर गोइंग टू नो अबाउट कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. सम ऑफ द टाइप्स ऑफ कनेक्टिव टिश्यूज फिनिश्ड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास. टुडे आल्सो अनदर कनेक्ट वन मोर कनेक्टिव टिश्यू रिमेन्स, दैट इज ब्लड. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू नो अबाउट द ब्लड. ब्लड इज वन ऑफ द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. सो इट इज डिफर्स फ्रॉम अदर टाइप्स ऑफ कनेक्टिव टिश्यू बिकॉज different types of cells in blood and each one has a different function. You know that blood, in the blood there are no fibers. There are different types of cells in the blood and each one have different function. Already you studied in the sixth class also, diversity of cells. So all the cells in the blood floats freely in the plasma. So what are the components of blood? Blood contain different blood cells in the form of solid, means cells are solid state, and these are floats in the fluid part, that is called as plasma. So this extracellular space is filled with fluid called plasma. What is plasma? You know, different types of cells, these cells are freely float in the fluid, that is extracellular space. That fluid is extracellular space, that is filled within the blood cells. So that's why this is called as plasma. You know that nearly 7 types of cells are present in the present. 7 types of blood cells are present. Those are mainly 3 types of blood cells. What are they? Red blood cells, white blood cells, and blood platelets. Again, white blood cells are 2 types depending upon granules, granulocytes and agranulocytes. Again, granulocytes 3 types and agranulocytes 2 types. These are the types of blood cells. Now, the red stream that flows in the closed tubes is blood. Where does blood is present? Blood is present in the closed tube-like structures. Those are called as blood vessels. They also a type of connective tissue, and this is red in color. You know that what is the reason the blood is red in color? Presence of protein, that is hemoglobin. And but blood is not always red in color. Means, do all organisms has a red blood color? Blood is red in color? No. Some organisms or some insects, that is mainly cockroach, the blood color of cockroach is white. What is reason? First of all, what is the reason to blood is red in color? Hemoglobin. So in the cockroach, hemoglobin is not present. That's why blood of cockroach is white in white color. And the snail, it has blue colored blood. And earthworm, it is red in blood is red in color, but hemoglobin is present in the plasma. Okay, so that's why all organisms does not contain the red colored blood, and some organisms has different colored blood also. And normally adult human being has 5 liters of blood. If anybody does not have the approximately 5 liters of blood, it is causes to the different problems. So 5 liters of blood is necessary for each adult human. And plasma also contains factors responsible for blood clotting. You know that one of the important process is required when we have the injury, that is blood clotting. How it done already you study. So the factors which are responsible for blood clotting, that is present in the plasma also. And another one, you know that in the blood vessels, blood does not have the any agglutination or blood clots. If any blood clots are present in the blood vessels, that is very dangerous, it leads to death. So how it is possible without formation of any clumps or any blood clotting in the blood vessels? One of the substances present in the in our blood, that is called as heparin. This heparin is also called as agglutination. anticoagulant. Sorry, this heparin is also called as anticoagulant. This is helps to prevent the blood clotting in the blood vessels. Okay, now let us see the types of blood vessels. So how many types of blood vessels are there? Three types of blood vessels. Red blood cells. Sorry, how many types? Not blood vessels. Sorry, how many types of blood cells are there? Three types of blood cells. Red blood cells, white blood cells, and blood platelets. Now, first one is red blood cells. So, other name of red blood cells is erythrocytes. Other name of red blood cells is erythrocytes. They are red in color because of the presence of red colored protein, that is called hemoglobin. Next, what is the function of red blood cells? Starting, I mentioned each red blood cell can perform their own function. So what is the function of red blood cells? It can transport the oxygen and carbon dioxide, exchange of gases. It helps to oxygen mixes into the blood and removal of carbon dioxide from the blood, that is carried by red blood cells, especially present in the presence of hemoglobin. Next one, how much red blood cells are present in the blood? If you take 1 ml of blood, these red blood cells are maybe 5 million of cells will be present. So this each red blood cell, the lifespan of red blood cells is 120 days. After 120 days, they will destroy and new blood cells are formed. Where does these new blood cells are formed? When you are in the mother's womb, your RBCs are formed in liver and spleen. In the mother's womb, red blood cells are formed in the liver and spleen. These are the internal organs of our body. And after birth, these red blood cells are generated from bone marrow of long bone. So when we are adult, after birth, where does red blood cells are produced? The bone marrow. All mammals except camel and llama have red blood cells without nucleus. Know that red blood cells contain nucleus, but only camel only camel and llama have the nucleus, and other are does not contain the nucleus. Next type of blood cells, white blood cells. These white blood cells does not contain hemoglobin, that's why they are colorless and they are called as leukocytes. And this number is when compared with red blood cells, less in number. And these white blood cells are depending upon granules, two types, that is granulocytes and agranulocytes. Again, granulocytes three types: neutrophils, basophils, eosinophils. So what is function of neutrophils? These are microscopic and policemen, means it can first line of defense, means it can protect the diseases. When the disease causing organism enters in our body, they can fight against. So that's why it can helps to defense, means giving protection. These are acts like a policeman. And basophils, these cells can attack and destroys the microorganisms that enters the body. All the white blood cells, any type, first they can fight against disease causing organisms. Next one is eosinophils. Some white blood cells sacrifice their life against fighting about the disease causing organisms or enemies. You see, in the war, during the war, some soldiers sacrifice their life. So like that, white blood cells, some of the white blood cells can sacrifice their life against the fight against the enemies. And these dead white blood cells come out of the wound as a pus. So after destroying, these white blood cells needs to comes out. So how they can comes out? In the form of pus. Next type of white blood cells are agranulocytes. These agranulocytes are two types, lymphocytes and monocytes. So what is the function of lymphocytes? It can secrete antibodies to guard against foreign materials that enter into the blood. So to get the protection from the diseases, when the disease causing organisms enters in the body, immediately the blood cells can produces against that by the producing the antibodies. That secretion of antibodies are done by lymphocytes. And monocytes, they can move like amoeba and attack the foreign materials and engulf them. These are also fight against the disease organisms, and the foreign materials and destroys inside this called as scavengers. So these monocytes can, the dead cells are cleaned by taking them. So that's why these are called scavengers, means make them clean. These monocytes can help to that. That's why these cells are generally called as scavengers. Next type of blood cells, platelets. These cells do not have nucleus and they are disc-like projections. You know that whatever is the importance of blood platelets. They accumulate at the site of injury and help to formation of blood clot. And clot seals the wound in the blood vessels and can prevent the further loss of blood. So this is the function of blood platelets. Now, you know that we are having the different types of blood groups. So another relation is there, your sisters and brothers, not your relatives. But it is true, if you take into consideration the blood groups, they may not have the same blood group as yours, but some members, they don't know, we don't know about them, but we have the same blood group. That is the relation of blood group. These blood groups are discovered by Landsteiner. He was a German doctor. Found a new blood relation among, he divided the human beings' blood into four groups: A, B, AB, and O. Among these, AB blood group is called as universal recipient. Recipient means receiving. This, if anybody have the blood group AB, any blood group they can suitable to receive blood group from A, group from B, group from AB and O also. So these are the suitable to receive the any group of blood. That's why AB blood group is called as universal recipient. And O group of blood is called as universal donor. These O group persons are preferred to donate the blood to any group of blood, that is A, B, AB and O. Only for donating any group. That's why O group is called universal donor. These two are important for bits. Which group is universal recipient? AB. Which group is universal donor? O. Why? What is the reason? Let us see. To understand about these groups, here lab activity is given. You see the textbook. So here what is the aim? Identification of blood group. Aim is identification of blood group. And materials, what are the blood identification kit, glass slide, these are all are given in the textbook. Just you see the textbook, you know that blood, what are the components of blood? Plasma and blood cells, especially RBC. So in the RBC, depending upon the what are the components present, antigens and antibodies. So antigens, antibodies determines the blood group. Various antigens are present, various antibodies are present. So in the blood, RBC and plasma. So you see here table, if the blood group A, antigens surface of RBC. First one is antigens. Next one, various antibodies in the plasma. Once again, various antigens surface of RBC. Antibodies are present in the plasma. In the surface of RBC, antigen A is present. What is present in the plasma? Antibody B is present. The antigen is A, antibody is B. The blood group is A blood group. Next one, antigen is B and antibody is A. So that blood group is B. Next one, AB group. So here antigens on the surface of RBC both are present. Antigens both A, B. So that's why antibodies does not, any antibodies does not present in the plasma. So that blood group is AB. Next one is O. Surface of RBC, no any antigen, either A or B antigens are not present. So automatically antibodies A and B both are present. So that's why that blood group is O. Are you clear? Depending upon antigens, antibodies. Antigens are present on the surface of red blood cells. Antibodies present in the plasma. So if the antigens A is present, antibody B is present. So that blood group is A. In the surface of RBC, antigen B is present. So what is antibody? Antibodies are A. So that blood group is AB. So blood group AB, both antigens are present. Antigens are present on surface of RBC, both antigens are present. So antibodies are absent. In the O group, antigens are absent and antibodies both are present. That blood group is O. Okay, so this is the determination of blood group. So determination of blood group based on agglutination. So here some process is there, Rh factor. Have you ever heard the Rh factor? This is rhesus factor, Rh. Generally, if the Rh factor causes to the blood clot, that is called as Rh positive, not cause Rh negative. Majority of the people are having the Rh factor negative. So depending upon that, so here antigens, only here antigens are given. Antigen A is present. So antigen B, no. But what is present here? Antibody is present. So here antigen A and antigen B is absent. That group is A. Next one, antigen A is absent. So antigen B is present. So that is a B group. And next one, sir, antigen A present, antigen B present. So that group is, antibodies are absent. So that's why blood group AB. Next one, antigen A is absent, antigen B is also absent. So blood group is O. So Rh is the slower to agglutinate. Agglutinates blood clumps or blood clotting. So do not give up to the Sundini. Rh factor helps to slow down the agglutination. So that's why do not give up to soon. And during the process of blood test, if agglutination occurs in anti-RHD serum, then Rh factor is positive. So when we add in the Rh factor, if blood can becomes a clot or agglutination occurs, that is called as Rh positive. If we can add the RHD, agglutination does not occur, that is called as Rh factor negative. So this is the determination of blood group. Are you clear? I hope all are understood. So many questions are there in this topic. You study the textbook, you read the textbook. These are all the important points you note in our notebook and study well. It is further it is useful to yourselves. Okay, bye.